Days were filled with guns and war, and everyone got trampled on the floor. I wish we'd all been ready. Children die, the days grow cold. A piece of bread could buy a bag of gold. I wish we'd all been ready. There's no time to change your mind. The sun has come and you've been left behind. A man and wife asleep in bed. She hears a noise and turns her head. He's gone. I wish we'd all been ready. Two men walking up a hill. One disappears, the other left standing still. I wish we'd all been ready. There's no time to change your mind. The sun has come and you've been left behind. The father spoke, the demons died. The sun has come and you've been left behind. You've been left behind.
World going. It's coming to an end.
The appointed time is coming upon all men. Wars and rumors of war with violence the trend. Boundless atrocities, ISIS in their inhumanity. Terrorism raging with growing intensity.
While famines destroy our food supply, earthquakes and tsunamis cause thousands to die. Global warming makes our forests fry. And the Earth's oil supply is running dry.
Refugees seek safety in other lands. Civil unrest, the blood on men's hands. The hearts of men are failing them for fear. As everywhere we turn, dreadful news we hear.
The countdown is on.
Watch for the signs.
The writing is on the wall.
Read between the lines.
It's getting late. For the great planet Earth.
Late!
world of sin and death. Their prophecies spoke of great destruction and horror, but always with the promise that at the end, salvation will come for the earth and its people. Jesus said, "We will know the end is near when Jerusalem once again is the city of the people of Israel and the temple of God stands on the holy mountain. For the generation that sees the beginning of these things will not all pass away until all the prophecies of the end times and his return are fulfilled." Our generation has seen the beginning of these things. This generation is the generation of promise.
From the beginning, that when the time appointed comes upon all men, that some will understand the signs, as men could read red heavens before the storms begin. Generation of the end shall see the ancient words unfold within four decades span. And those who listen carefully hear the fig leaves rustle gently, will know fulfillment is at hand.
This generation,
it is said by He who made this world, when Israel shall find its home, the children of that hour will not see death before the sky is torn apart to show the Sacred One in power. This is that generation now that saw the dead, dried bones arise and resurrect the land, and resurrect the land, and resurrect the land.
This generation.
foretell that in the days of the end, men will turn from the worship of the true God and function and fashion their own truth from the darkest recesses of their own imagination. The ancient deceiving serpent will lead them to grovel before times and fates. Searching the movement of the stars, they will corrupt the earth with sorcery. We say to you, these things are happening now.
Step up, sit down, let me see your part.
Themselves to God's truth and following lies, we are told in scripture that the church will draw together, not in faith, but in a greater lie. denying the truth and the power of the Bible and the living word for the sake of vanities and dreams and building kingdoms of earthly power.
Now if the church is gonna prosper, we need a more progressive posture. No time to waste, we got to organize. We need a super church to guide us. Forget the doctrines that divide us. The time has come for a little compromise.
Yes, Lord!
What's we need a brand new gospel. The old one's just too holy master.
You can't make friends by trampling on their toes. People don't want no guilt and sorrow. They want a brighter day tomorrow. And someplace they can wear their newest clothes.
Yes, Lord!
Forget the resurrection thesis. We just want the words of Jesus on brotherhood and love and no more war. The miracles can be dispensed with. There's no need to be incensed with arguments on doctrine anymore.
Yes, Lord!
Do's and don'ts that only give you guilt. We won't try to change your living. There's nothing left that needs forgiving. Your life is short, so live it to the hill.
Yes, Lord!
Social revolution, praying never made solutions to poverty or inner city crime. Broad-mindedness sure beats dogmatics. We wouldn't want to be fanatics. A person's got to keep up with the times.
Yes, Lord!
Now if the church is gonna prosper, we need a more progressive posture. The time to waste, we've got to organize. We need a super church to guide us.
Children of Adam, drowning in the distortions and confusion. Come and weep for the devastation that is surely near. Weep and yet rejoice that the coming of the Holy King is soon at hand. And when he comes, what will he find in the midst of his people? Will our life together stand against the test of that time?
I see you standing in your corner, enclosed in walls of sacred stone, while I watch through painted windows, just as distant and alone. If eyes meet, we smile politely, thinking definitions, thinking names, quick to catch the subtle differences, never seeing we're the same. Canticles of separation, chanting hallowed, highest best, without shadow, lonely altars we ignore, the stifled tears in whitewashed tombs of our distinction, fondling bones as if they live. We offer silences for anguish, finding nothing else to give. Oh, why can't we learn? Tell me, why can't we see that the body's being broken, that we're tearing it apart? It was broken once and meant it, meant to last for a time. But when the hand is turned against the eye, we're crippled, blind, we die. We break dry bread to eat in shadows, drinking cups of soured wine, while the wheat fields lie abandoned. Tangled branches choke the vine. Oh, why can't we learn? Tell me, why can't we see that the body's being broken, that we're tearing it apart? It was broken once and meant to last for all time. Oh, heal me with your hands, let me show you eyes. Let the body grow between us, let it reach out far beyond. Let the body that was broken come together in us now. Oh, won't you take my eyes to see? Give me your spirit to say. Together with the flesh and bones of the Son of the Great High King. Yeah, 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 yeah. We gotta love each other. We gotta start treating each other as brother and sister. We can't do it on our own. We need each other. Yeah, 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 yeah. Yeah, 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 yeah. We gotta work together. We gotta start obeying Jesus and living together as brother and sister. Yeah, yeah. We gotta love each other. Yeah, yeah, yeah. We gotta love each other. Yeah, yeah. We gotta start treating each other, yeah, yeah, as brothers and sisters. We gotta work together, yeah, yeah. We gotta love each other, yeah, 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 yeah. We gotta start treating each other as brothers and sisters, loving one but serving the Savior. Yeah, 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 yeah.
Nation will rise against nation, bringing famine and death, pestilence and earthquake upon the land. From east, west, north and south, they will gather to do battle.
Ethiopia, 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 at the valley of Megiddo and the plains of the desert.
Men of all nations, went for his calling, he returned from the place of the rest.
7 days, God created all that is. 7 lamps burn in the hands of 7 angels before the face of God's majesty. 7 seals bind the scrolls of man's destiny. 7 is the number of the Holy One in his power and glory. It is written that 7 spirits will sound 7 trumpets to herald the kingdom of the Lord. And before the last trumpet is heard, there will be poured out from heaven 7 bowls of judgment upon the wickedness of the world and all its people.
There's a day soon coming when the judgments of the world will begin. When the skies will be darkened and the mountains dance like drunken men.
His birth has fought against his brother, so at the end, the kingdom kingdoms of the north shall align with Egypt and the kingdoms of the south to attack the land of Israel. Their mighty army shall ravage and thunder and burn.
Before the heavenly King.
Life will be opened. Those whose names are not found there will be cast into eternal fire. But those whom the Father has chosen will stand before him in joy and feast at the great banquet of the Lamb.
Is your name written in the book of life? Will you sit at the feast of the Lamb? Will you taste of the ancient, immortal food of life? Will you walk into the promised land? To his children he promises a name of grace and perpetual life in the sun of his face. It is yours for the taking. If you ask, it will be. Don't turn away, or you'll never be free. Restores them here, and they sit at the table of peace. In this great celebration of those his love has healed, will you share this joy that cannot cease? To his children he promises a name of grace and perpetual life in the sun of his face. It is yours for the taking. If you ask, it will be. Don't turn away, or you'll never be. Apart from the freedom his love has released, take his hand, come join in the Lamb's holy feast.
After a thousand years, we will see a new heaven and a new earth, and a new Jerusalem descending like a bride out of heaven. And a voice will cry, "This is the holy city. Here God lives among men. They shall be his people, and he shall be their God forever."
Jerusalem, city of lights, set upon Zion. sometime. Anyone here for the very first time to St. Augustine Evangelical Bible Church? We want to see you. So could you stand and the rest of us will give you a round of applause. Those here for the first time. I don't see anybody. We are so happy to see you. And we have a little package for you. It's a gift. And also, I have a little gift for everybody here. You see, what you just witnessed was Ha Lindsay's exposition on the prophecies concerning the return of Jesus. Now, not everybody sees it exactly the same way. But what I want to say to you is that it is, if it's a prophecy, it's biblical prophecy, it's the word of God, it is a promise from God. And what was it about? It was about the return of Jesus Christ. Now, as the psalm says, it's getting late. And that is not to push you into fear, but to place you onto saving faith. So I want to tell you a little bit about promises. Faith in a promise is really believing that what God says he will do. I want to give an example, an old one. The prophet said as much as 700 years before that Jesus Christ would come, that he would be a descendant of David, King David, that he would be born in Bethlehem, 2, that he would be born of a virgin, 3, that he would be betrayed by a friend, 4, that he would be traded for 30 pieces of silver, 5, that he would not be, that is not a single bone on his body would be broken, 6, that he would be pierced for our transgressions, 7, that he would not, his body would not suffer decay, 8, I'll stop there because there are hundreds. The statisticians say that if one man had to fulfill those 8 prophecies over such a long period of time, it would be 10 to the 7th power, 17th power. Now, 10 by 10 by 10, 17 times, we have no concept of that. Because if you take one grain of rice and put it on a second square and you had 2, if you do that for 16 squares, you would make a mountain of rice as large as Mount Everest. So 10 by 10, 17 times is beyond our imagination. So for Jesus to fulfill those 8 promises, and he fulfilled far more, it was like taking 25 cent pieces and putting it all over Curep as deep as 2 feet. And someone going and picking out just the right one. It's that incredible for Jesus to fulfill those 8 promises, and he fulfilled many. Now, Jesus himself said, if you destroy this body, I will pick it up in 3 days. After that, he said in John 14, let not your hearts be troubled. In my Father's house, there are many rooms. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go to prepare a place for you, I will come back to take you so that where I am, there you will be also. Thomas said, Jesus said, you know the way to where I'm going, to the place I'm going. Thomas said, we don't even know where you're going, how are we going to know the way? Right? Jesus said, and that famous verse that all of us know, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man comes unto the Father but by me. Look at that tremendous promise. And how did Thomas respond to it? With doubt. He had to see the hand, he had to see the holes and the piercing in his side to believe. That was how Thomas responded to that true prophecy of Jesus himself. And what about Noah? God promised that there would be a flood. And though it took 100 years to build the ark, and about 120 years for him to warn people, how many people actually believed and went into the ark? Just 8 people. Noah and his wife, and his 3 sons and their wives. So how did the people in Noah's time respond to that prophecy? Not very well. There was also a prophecy in Ezekiel 26. Check it out yourself. God said to the prophet that these people in the land of Tyre, a city, the Phoenician, I can't pronounce that name, of the Chaldean kind of people, those people in the land of Tyre, the city of Tyre, that city would be totally destroyed, that their city would be scraped clean, and the rubble would be thrown into the ocean, and fishermen will dry their nets there, and it will never be rebuilt. 3 years after that prophecy, Nebuchadnezzar went to attack that city. But because these people were great conquerors and because they were great navigators, while that country was under siege, they took their boats and they went half mile into the sea on a little island, and they built their new city. So when Nebuchadnezzar came and he broke down the doors, no people from Tyre. So he destroyed the whole place. And the people of Tyre had 250 years to totally laugh. Guess what happened 250 years later? The great Alexander the Great came to Tyre, what was the city, and he asked those people for some help for his people. His army needed some refreshments. You know what the people said? They sent back messages to say, no way. Now, because they knew that they were half mile into the sea, Nebuchadnezzar couldn't reach them, they were feeling that this Alexander the Great would have a problem. But it really stirred his fury. And guess what he did? He and his men took the rubble from the broken down city and threw it into the ocean and made a causeway and utterly destroyed Tyre. And today, up to today, if you go, you'll see fishermen drying their nets on Tyre, and it has never been rebuilt. What do you have to say about that? Amazing. So the people of Noah, they had 120 years to juve and to old mass insults on Noah. The people of Tyre had 250 years to feel secure. And then now comes the prophecy before us today, in the 21st century, that Jesus Christ, he will return, and we have 2,000 years to feel secure, to laugh, to hurl insults at those who feel he will return. But I want to say to you that the promises of God are sure. Amen. And the promises of Jesus' return will definitely happen. Some people are saying it will not, but I'm telling you, just as scripture was fulfilled literally in the past, it will take place. We don't know when. But don't join a multitude to laugh or to ridicule. What the scripture says will definitely happen. Amen. I want to give you just a little moment in the quietness of your heart to take your faith and place it in Jesus. Do you know why? Because he's the great conqueror. He conquered the grave. He will destroy your sin if you confess them. And though your sins be as white as scarlet, he shall make them as white as freshly fallen snow. That is a promise of God, and he will give you a very, very bright and sure future when he returns. So in the quiet of your own heart, as all heads are bowed and all eyes closed, I want you to confess Jesus Christ as your Lord and ask him to forgive you of your sins and give you the assurance that when you die, you will go to be with him. Or if he returns before, that he will say, welcome into my kingdom. So I'll give you a minute. in the quiet of your own heart to respond to that promise of his return. And as simple as that was, if you placed your faith in Jesus, who is present with us right now, and if you ask him to forgive you of your sins, he would have removed from you the penalty of your sins. He would have also taken the wrath of God, would have been removed from you, and that place that he has prepared is reserved and kept in heaven for you. It will not rust. It will not spoil. It's waiting there for you. So that is the message of our concert, and we hope that it has found life in your heart. If you did that, as I pray, I want you also to come and speak with any member of the choir in white robes, or me, or any of the elders. So let's just pray. Let's stand. Heavenly Father, we thank you for your great and precious promises, because they give us all we need for life and for godliness and a hope for a real future with you in eternity. Father, we just praise you for all those who would have placed their confidence in the fact that you will return, and they want to be among those, O Lord, who will be taken with you. Father, we give you praise, we give you thanks. And for those who are still not sure, give them, O Lord, the courage to speak with someone. We give you praise in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen.